Dopamine is like the oil of the human body machine. It helps us to move smoothly and with purpose and with normal rhythm and cadence. By the time somebody develops Parkinson's disease, many of the brain cells in an area of the brain called the substantia nigra have died or are not functioning properly. These are the brain cells that really produce the brain chemical dopamine that is so vital. And without dopamine, we start to get many of the motor symptoms of the disease.
So early in the disease, we can have some digestive issues because dopamine is also in charge of the motility of the digestive system. We can have some gait and balance issues because dopamine is also involved in that. We can have some problem with the blood pressure because dopamine is also in charge of blood pressure, heart rate, etc. Dopamine doesn't only affect the motor activity of the body, it affects everything.
Parkinson's disease is currently a clinical diagnosis. People have, first and foremost, this slowness of movement or a smallness in their movement. They need to have a change in their movement. And then we pair that with things like stiffness on examination or with tremor, mainly when people have their limbs at rest. We do have multidisciplinary care here at Yale, and in our clinics, patients can be evaluated by a movement disorder specialist, but also the multidisciplinary team that includes social work to address things like their mental health or their needs at home.
And this is what we have here in the Center of Neuromodulation and the Movement Disorder Center in the Department of Neurology. We work together. So we have meetings twice a week. We see patients together. And we only do it in order to get the best result for the patients.
Because the disease can be so individualized and people may have many different symptoms, the care also has to be super individualized. The therapies that we have for Parkinson's disease are really incredible.
Usually we would do surgeries, like deep brain stimulus surgeries, only when medication fails. Now we know that the sooner you have deep brain stimulus surgery, the better the patients will do. And there's also some theories that maybe shows that if you do deep brain stimulation surgery early in the disease, you might be able to postpone the progression of the disease. This stimulation inhibits the activity of this specific area, and by that we can almost make the tremors go away, the rigidity, and we can reduce the medication dose and avoiding side effects by that.
We are on the path to try and find the cure for Parkinson's disease, something that stops or slows down the progression. So before they're stiff or they're slow or they have tremor, people will describe having many years of constipation or poor sense of smell, or maybe they act out their dreams. And these are symptoms that we think precede the onset and may give us a clue that someone may develop Parkinson's disease. And if we have these signs, then maybe we can intervene and prevent them from developing Parkinson's disease.
How can we inhibit the progression of the disease? So we know that dopamine is missing, right? We know exactly what is the gene that is making dopamine. We did the gene therapy surgery. We implanted the gene to the GPI, which is another area in the brain, with the gene for dopamine. We were hoping that by implanting the gene for dopamine, the brain will be able to reproduce dopamine again. This is one step forward, maybe, hopefully, to cure Parkinson's.
And clinical trials about our theories of what could slow down disease progression or stop disease in its tracks is going to be the only way we find that cure for Parkinson's disease. That's our holy grail of research, and we hope to get there.